And I now give the floor to Ms. Leila Serugi. You have the floor, ma'am.
Monsieur le Président, Excellences, Mesdames et Messieurs, c'est un honneur pour moi de m'adresser au Conseil de sécurité pour la première fois en ma qualité de représentante spéciale pour les enfants et les conflits armés. The situations in Libya, Syria and Mali, for example, pose new threats for children that this Council, along with my office and its partners, must address. The situation for children in Syria is dire. My staff and other United Nations colleagues have documented government attacks on schools, children denied access to hospitals, girls and boys suffering and dying in bombardments of their neighborhoods, and also being subject to torture, including sexual violence, sometimes for weeks. Since the publication of this report, my office has also gathered evidence on violations committed by non-state armed groups in Syria. We have received information concerning indiscriminate bomb attacks which have killed children in Damascus and other areas, and continue to document incidents committed by armed actors such as the Free Syrian Army, who may have children associated with their forces. I have met with the Syrian permanent representative with regard to our concerns. I have ensured the ambassador that I am ready to establish an open dialogue with the Syrian authorities as a sign of good faith towards their moral and legal obligations. In this regard, I have also asked the ambassador to transmit my call to the Syrian armed forces to evacuate schools as a matter of utmost priority. In Libya, the localized violence and continued presence of so-called armed brigades threaten the lives of children long after the generalized violence of 2011 has come to an end. It remains of concern that incidents of association of children with armed groups are still being reported. My office has been in close contact with the Libyan mission in New York to strategize about how best to address the remaining threats to children in the Libyan context. Since its inception in March 2012, the crisis in Mali has been characterized by grave violations against children. Hundreds of cases of recruitment and use of children by the MNLA, as well as by Ansar al-Din and Mujao, have been reported. Particularly alarming are recent reports of new training camps in northern Mali run by armed groups. Sexual violence against children, especially by the MNLA, is also of great concern. In the Democratic Republic of